Dear prospective learners, ever since the launching of MJMC in 2018, our endeavor has been to provide the learners with the necessary skill sets to work effectively in print, electronic, as well as web medium. Simultaneously, we have also tried to impart among our learners a holistic knowledge of the society and the context where they would be working as journalists. So the course or the program on MJMC is a perfect blend of theory and practice, comprising of 64 units spread across 4 semesters. The learner, in order to obtain an MJMC degree, has to clear 16 papers, 15 compulsory and 1 elective. So that is how the program, the MJMC, is so designed. I will hereby give you some insights into the course content that we have in MJMC, and what will be its overall impact for the career of the learner as a journalist. Initially, we have designed our courses in a manner that the learner doesn't feel left out after he leaves the university. For instance, there is a perfect combination of courses which were traditionally offered in journalism schools, such as we have a place for papers like communication theory, communication concepts, ethics, history of press. We also have papers on print journalism, electronic journalism, television and radio journalism. And at the same time, we also offer them papers on emerging areas of journalism, such as emerging and social media practices and new media and computer applications. So the courses are so designed that the new areas of journalism as well as the old traditional areas are given equal importance. Certain papers, certain theoretical papers which are meant to give the learners an idea about the socio-political contexts in which they will work as journalists, have also been included in the syllabus. We have papers like international and intercultural communication. We have papers like media and margins, media sociology, development communication. Now, these papers basically try and groom a journalist as an holistic individual. It is not enough that you possess the necessary skill sets, that you possess the necessary skills required to work as a journalist. Reporting and editing are of course important, but at the same time you must know what's going around, what's happening in the world that you live around, and how are the social paradigms, or how are the other elements, socio-political elements, shaped, and knowing about it will enable you to work as a better journalist. At the same time, we have with us 4 electives. We provide 4 electives, and the primary objective is to give you some kind of a specialization that you need to after you graduate from the university. We have papers like multimedia, we have papers like media management, advanced photojournalism, which we offer as electives. Now, these papers will broaden your horizon, they broaden your possibilities after you graduate from the university. For instance, you can work as a photojournalist, you can work as a manager, you can work in the management department of a media organization. So it's not necessary that you work as a reporter and an editor, that is, you are confined to these two operations for the rest of your life. So the course also intends to broaden your horizon, to increase your sphere after you graduate. So it is, in short, a very well-balanced course. It is rooted in tradition, and at the same time, it acknowledges the modern developments that have taken place in the field. And more than that, it also enables you to try your hands in other areas with success, in areas such as film studies, areas such as media management, photojournalism, corporate communications, which we offer in the electives, which we offer as elective papers, also enable you to try your hands in other allied fields. We have a paper called Development Communication. Those who take interest in development communication can actually seek a career for themselves in NGOs. Successfully, they can work in NGOs. They will be good at filing development stories for the media organizations that they work in. So in all, the emphasis is both on skills as well as developing you as a holistic journalist. Now coming to some other aspects or some other facets of this course, one of the major highlights of our NJMC program is the practical hands-on training which we do at Indian Institute of Mass Communication, Dhenkanal. Due to an arrangement which we have with IIMC, students or those who opt to are allowed to do an intensive 1 week practical training at Indian Institute of Mass Communication. They are given hands-on experience on many of the areas in communication, such as television, radio. They are given hands-on training in social media, mobile journalism, Mojo as they call them. So this constitutes one of the major highlights of the program. Rarely do you have a university offering journalism in ODL mode, which gives so much importance on practical training as well. Next, we have made it mandatory for our students to do a dissertation, which is based on some research work that they carry out in the field of communication. It is mandatory dissertation, which is compulsory paper. It is mandatory for a student to give a dissertation in order to successfully complete his course in MJMC. There are research guidelines which have been uploaded on our website. Following them, a learner is supposed to do a meaningful research on an area which is relevant to mass communication and journalism, and submit it before getting a degree. Now these apart, we have certain other features, or we provide many facilities to our learners. We have SLMs, self-learning materials, both online as well as offline, which are sent to the students by post as well as uploaded on our website. All our SLMs, ESLMs as we call them, are uploaded on our website. The learner can access them at will. We also have provisions for Sunday classes in our study centers. The students can attend them and they can interact with the counselors, as we call them, about the papers that they are currently taking in the semester. Our students are from different profiles. We have students who are freshers and are willing to do a degree in journalism. We also have students who are working journalists, and they are here to get a degree. And as such, they are journalists. They are already into the field. They are working. And at the same time, we also have a sizable number of students who, after having completed their PGTJMC from institutes as reputed as IGNO and Indian Institute of Mass Communication, they come to get a degree in journalism and mass communication from Odisha State Open University. So if you happen to be one of these categories, our doors are always open for you. You can take part in the admission process, the registration process, and be a part of the OSU fraternity. Thank you.